Hi everyone, this video is all about micro interactions. What are they? Just like, I'll show you actually, it's easier. See this kind of blue box with the arrow we did earlier? Watch when I click login. Slides across and changes color. Cool, huh? So it's like a tiny bit of animation to help clarify to the user what's going on, kind of help reinforce what you're trying to communicate. There's lots of other things we're gonna do as well. It's probably easy just to show you, like I'm at Dribbble, so Dribbles with three Bs. And I've done a search here for micro interactions to give you some examples. But regardless of looking at the examples, a micro interaction would be this. See this little liking this icon? If I like that, see the little heart changes to red? That's a micro interaction. It's not like a big transition from, you know, one page to another, like prototyping. It's just like a little bit of user feedback to help you know that you've done the right thing. If it didn't change color and the number didn't go up, you'd wonder if you've clicked it or not. So that's like a basic one. Let's look at some kind of nicer ones. Now what you can do is you can hover above the GIF. You can see there, this one's playing. So you're looking for the ones that are GIFs in Dribbble, because that'll give you kind of a visual aid there. You can see there, you're clicking on these things, that button there, it's hard to point to it and roll off the GIF. But you can see they're clicking on the button and it's just kind of like giving some sort of visual feedback. This is quite like a really pretty, like there's lots going on in that micro interaction. Okay, it gets even further, this one here, like a page build. Click on that, ooh, look, that was nice. You can see there's a nice like transition between screens. Okay, there's little interactions. So the prototyping would be the moving between screens, but how it gets there and how it starts kind of like displaying the information, it's kind of got that nice little slide. It's giving you some sort of visual feedback. Okay, so those are micro interactions. Let's have a look at some other ones. Okay, when a page is loading, that little thing spinning around. micro interaction, that's just straight up animation. So I guess that's where it's kind of, you gotta work it out. Ooh, that's a good one. You know the little bell that appears, you've got a little notification. It's a little bit more feedback. Often they can be quite simple, but you can get pretty elaborate as well. All right, let's jump in and start making our own micro interaction. All right, let's start with one down here in our app, okay? So some animation can be done in web, loads more can be done in an app. So if you are kind of like selling the client on this like beautiful micro interaction, just double check it can actually be physically made in your program. So this thing here, for some reason, there are different colors. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to make sure they're the right color. I could join them as, you know, I could fuse them as one thing, but I wanna do something with them, with my little micro interaction. So on this page, this indicates sign up. When you get over here, it indicates login. So I'm gonna animate between the two. The way to do it is, if I click this login button here, I'm gonna switch to prototype. Remember the shortcut? It's control tab on both Mac and PC. Okay, and we've just done transitions like this. When it clicks, we go tap and it transitions. What we're gonna do is gonna tap and auto animate. This should say micro interaction it. Okay, but it's just auto animate. So what it's going to do is, it's going to try and animate between the two here. Let's just give it a run and see what it looks like. So I've got the home set on my app. I'm gonna give it a preview. I'm gonna click on login. It just does it automatically. Cool, hey? I'm gonna go back, preview again, and watch this click. You can see both that changes color and moves across. The way this works, if yours is not working, you'd be like, hey, mine doesn't work. What needs to happen is they need to be the same. So this blue box transitions over to here to be this green box. Now, these guys need to be both the same kind of shape. As in shape, as in like primitive. It needs to be, you know, this can't transition into this word John Doe. Okay, it can't change form into text. Okay, so these are similar things, both rectangles, and this it can go into circles, but they just need to be, yeah, can't go into text or an image. Say the other thing they need to do is they need to have the same name. And where do you find their name? Okay, you find their names in the layers panel. Okay, click on layers panel down the bottom here, and you can see he's called rectangle 145. I click on this guy. He's also called 145. So if they have different names, just rename them. And when I said before they have to have the same kind of primitive shape, you can see here, that is showing me a rectangle, it's a type, that thing there is a Boolean. So they need to be this, they have the same icons and have the same name. You can rename them afterwards. If this was wrong, you can just double click it and rename it and it should connect up. Cool, huh? Now, if you're trying to connect things that are inside like, where we go, this one here. So if you want to connect things that are inside, what do we got here? Actually go to design. And these guys are inside a repeat grid, or no, these guys are inside of a symbol. So you can still do it, but what you need to do is you need to be able to double click to go inside of it. So grab prototype. I want when somebody clicks the word courses, so I'm going to double click it to get inside. I'm going to go in here, okay, and I'm going to say, it'll remember the last thing you've done. So I can leave it as auto animate. It's going to go to the courses page. I'm going to leave all the easing fine. Let's give it a preview. Make sure dashboard is selected or you make it home, either one. Give it a preview. Click on courses, ready? Oh, cool. It fades across because it doesn't know what to do with lots of it, so it just fades it. And that little thing moved. Let's have a look at one of the other ones. So once you get to courses, if you click on, what's another page? Academy. Okay, so down here, if I click on Academy, I could zoom out. I'm going to use the other trick. Okay, I'm going to go back to, which one am I going back to? The Academy. Academy video. Cool, and it's going to use auto animates. But if I click on dashboard, that's going to do the same thing. Nice. Academy here. All right, and what does this one go to? Dashboard can go here. You can see it's easier when you can see them, but when you can't, it's easier just to go you and go to courses. All right, so I'll start this as my beginning, just because. Let's go to dashboard. You see that little blue box, animate? Oh, so cool. So those are simple micro interactions. What we'll do now is we'll kind of work through this section in the different videos just to kind of isolate them as this is just like, that's a simple thing. Let's do some smarter, at least sexier micro interactions so you know it's available to you. And remember to get inspiration for them, go to that Dribbble site and just make sure you're typing in micro interaction, or if you just type in UI and type in GIF, you will get like both UI, but you'll also get these GIF things because that's what you want. You hover above the word GIF. Because you really want to see, ooh, let's look at this one. I don't know what it is, but I feel like it's going to be good. Ooh, so good. Again, this is moving from, I wouldn't say that a micro interaction, that's just like full on animation. It kind of a micro interaction, but it's kind of presented as an animation, right? If you clicked on a button and it did all these things, you'd be confused as hang. So look at this one. I feel like this one could be a good one. Then we'll move on. Oh, it turned into a cursor. Brilliant. Magic unicorn wins. Team Unicorn. All right, I will see you in the next video. Hi there, I hope you enjoyed the video. My name is Daniel Scott. If you would like to do the full course, there'll be a link in the description for that. Please give this video on YouTube here a thumbs up. It really helps me and what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to the channel. I release a video like this every week for your viewing pleasure. All right, bye.